In this video, we'll demonstrate how a supplier of computer accessories receives orders from its website and puts order items into an IBM MQ queue for processing. These items will be read from queues, processed, and then inserted as records into a DB2 ITEMS table. To achieve this, we can use the IBM MQ connector in IBM App Connect in a container environment to build an API to interact with an IBM MQ instance. We will create two flows. The first one is a flow for an API which accepts the purchase order XML and puts the order items into a queue. The other is an event-driven flow which triggers whenever a new message is received on the IBM MQ configured queue and performs an insert operation in the database. The first flow can be exposed as an API that can be invoked by other applications, whether it's their e-commerce website or mobile application. First, we'll create an action flow in the IBM App Connect designer using the XML parser and IBM MQ put message on a queue node. As part of the purchase order model, we have attributes such as ID and request XML. Here, request XML is an invoice or purchase orders details in XML format. We click on operations and then edit flow. To perform the IBM MQ put operation on the purchase order, we need to pass the request XML and extract a list of items in XML that we want to put in the configured queue. For passing the request XML, we use the XML parser node from the App Connect Designer toolbox. This will provide a list of items for the request XML. Then we'll use the for each node from the toolbox to iterate items in XML and perform the IBM MQ put message on a queue operation on each of the items in XML. To do that, first we'll configure the queue name where the put operation is being performed and select message type as text. Then for the message payload, we select XML as the items are in XML format. This needs to be mapped with the request properties, which we can do by clicking the mapping icons. The available mappings are displayed and we can select the ones we want to use from the list. Next, we'll create an event-driven flow with IBM MQ, an XML parser, and a JDBC node. This flow will trigger whenever any new messages are received on the configured queue. In this flow, we'll add an IBM MQ new message on a queue node, XML parser node, and JDBC custom query node. In the IBM MQ new message on a queue node, we'll configure the same queue name that we configured on our IBM MQ put message on a queue operation in the flow for an API. After that, we'll use the XML parser node to pass the XML items retrieved from the IBM MQ new message on a queue node. The XML parser node will extract items from XML. Then we'll perform a custom query action with an insert query on the items table in the database to insert items in the corresponding table by mapping values from the output of the XML parser node. Now we'll start both the flows. Here is my purchase order API. Now I want to test it. In the request XML, we are passing invoice details in XML format and we can see two items, MacBook Pro and mouse. Before sending the request, let me check if I have any orders in the database items table. We can see we don't have any data on the items table. Now I'll send the request. Okay, now the items are inserted in the items table. So we'll verify the items table in the database. And we can see we have two entries in the items table. We have shown by using flows created in the IBM App Connect designer how we can design an integration that performs an insert operation using the IBM MQ connector.